Today's session, we are going to talk about in detail about the decision trees. How decision trees are different from others. Like so far, we discussed about the logistic regression, linear regression, and the correlation. Whereas in all the three cases, we discussed with the formula and we have the sum property. As a layman, I would like, even of course, in the logistic regression, we are making strategy, whereas in the linear regression also, we are making the strategy. Of course, we are going to make this strategy in decision tree also. But how decision trees are different from other algorithms? Other algorithm is nothing but logistic regression, linear regression. Here, decision trees, which are in the form of tree-based structure. Let's say, for example, you are traveling to your village, maybe your grandfather's native place or your father's native place, something. Maybe you are staying away from long time, let's say from last 20 years, 50 years. If someone asks you in that village, who are you? Will they recognize you directly? Definitely, they are not going to recognize you. And what you need to do, you have to tell either of the one person who are staying over there his name, so that people can able to recognize. So how do you tell? Let's say he's my cousin, he's my uncle, he's my aunt, he's my nephew, like that. You have to say, then only they will able to understand who are you. So let's say how the structure. First, your grandfather will be there. From your grandfather, your father, maybe your uncles, your aunties, and then after you, your daughter, your sister, all this thing, your brother, and from you, your kid, like this. It is a tree-sized format. Decision tree also well works for the categorical data. Of course, it works for the numerical data. Decision tree more works for the categorical data. If more number of the categorical data, what we have done yesterday in the logistic regression, we convert them into a numerical format, 0 and 1 format. But whereas in the decision tree, we doesn't require to convert them into 0 and 1 format. So what we need to do, we just have to do whatever the categories are, on top of those we are building the algorithm. How do we build that decision tree? While building the decision tree, what are the rules and things we need to follow? Let's have a discussion about those things. Introduction. First of all, what is segmentation? What is decision tree? How decision tree algorithm is different from the other algorithms? How do we split the attribute? How do we build the decision trees? How do we validating the model? Pruning, prediction using the models. Now, before we are going to discuss about that, first, let's have a discussion about what is segmentation. Segmentation means dividing the segments. Segment means groups. Dividing the data into various segments. Here, in this case, let's say, for example, I want to run a market camp. Let's say you are the owner of the More supermarket or Levi's showroom. Levi's class showroom. You want to run the campaign to get the. Why do you need to run the campaign? Why do you need to do the promotion to attract the more customers or new customer? For that, what we need to do, we have to do go with the one by one method. So first method will be, how do I target the customer? Do I need to do advertisement in the digital media? Digital media means it may be social media, web, all these things, Facebook, Google, all these things. Or do you want to send SMS? Or do you want to send through a mail? Or which age people you need to target? Let's say I want to sell the trouser like jeans. Do I need to target the who are the age more than 60? Will they able to wear their jeans? Ideally, no. Who I need to target? Youngsters whose age is less than 30. Of course, more than 35, 40 also they may wear, but the percentage of population is very less. So who is my right set of target audience? And SMS campaign. Do I need to target within the Bangalore location or do I need to target outside of the Bangalore location? Hyderabad, Chennai. So your shop is in Bangalore. The ultimate population, you coming from the Bangalore only. There is a very, very less chances people will come from Hyderabad or Chennai or nearby surrounded places. So your target area in which area you are targeting the people. That is also one thing you need to think about it. So based on this, we will do the segment. Let's say, imagine a scenario where we want to run the SMS marketing campaign to attract the more customers in the next quarter. For that, what we need to do? What some customers might come when we provide in the high discount. Buy two, get three. Buy two, get five. Brand factory. They are providing for you. Some customer want to see large number of collection. Let's say you spend 1,000 rupees, you will get the five clothes, six different. Some customers are the male customer, some customer are the female customer. Some customers might be just a brand for a particular product, or some customer only, let's say, they looking for the quality. Of course, we might provide in the discounts and offer, sometimes refabricated due to some just small mistakes in the cloth or in the product. They try to sell, those are called as refabricated products. Some products, they don't want anything, whatever the price will be, they want to have the good quality of the product. And how do we do it? Divide based on the buying pattern. Does the female are buying or does the male are buying? And the profile, does they have in the income? Let's say if I target the low income people where my product cost is around 6,000, 7,000 or 10,000, will they able to buy? They're not going to be, right? So while targeting the customer, which income people I need to target, which age people I need to target, does the female or male, what is the age of the product, where they are locating, all these things we need to target. Based on this, we need to do the segmentation. While doing the segmentation, population means group of all the entities are called as the population. In the population, low income people will be there, medium income people will be there, high income people will be there. But if the, am I going to target the entire population? To target the particular customer, we are not definitely going to target the entire population. We are going to target the only some set of the people. Here, one size, that means one entire population size, doesn't fit here. So what we need to do, we are going to divide homogeneous and heterogeneous. Homogeneous means same kind of behavior of the people. Let's say high income group, one group, medium income is the one group, low income is the one group. Whereas high income group like TV stars, movie actors, cinema stars, as well as a politician, they are staying in more in one located businessmen. Am I right? Let's say like us, we will stay near. Let's say some people might stay in some areas. With those are the low income. Depends on income, the people stay might be different. Let's say you are traveling to other city. We are looking for the 2-star, 3-star hotel. Let's say cine stars or VIP, they will look for the 5-star or 7-star. That is how the different will be. So the same kind of behavior of the people are called as the homogeneous. Various kind of behavior of the people are called across the group are called as the heterogeneous. Is there a statistical method to divide based on the data? Is there any statistical method to divide based on this method? Yes. The statistical method to divide homogeneous and heterogeneous groups, we are going to divide based on the decision trees. Okay. Any questions so far? Segmentation on the business problem. Here, in a segmentation, what we are going to do, here in this case, we have the this is the old data. Based on the old data, we are going to predict the new data. We have the three variables in this data set, which consist of gender, marital status, order the product. Yes means order the product. No means not ordering the product. In the new data, we are going to look into that. In the new data, we are going to look into that whether the customer will order the product or not. Based on the gender and marital status, we need to predict in the new data whether the customer will order the product or not order the product. We have an old data. In the old data, we have some set of records along with three variables. Those are gender, marital status, order the product. Based on this existing data, we would like to predict based on gender and order, marital status, whether the customer are going to order the product or not order the product. So we need to predict that, right? So in this business problem, there are total 14 customers are there. Out of that, 4 customers are ordering the product and remaining 10 customers are not ordering the product. Total 14 customers are there. Out of that, 4 customers are ordering the product. How many customers are not ordering the product? 10 customers are not ordering the product. Now, based on this, we would like to predict whether the customer will order the product or not for the new data. So the decision tree philosophy here, the data we have like this, and we need to rearrange the data. How do we rearrange the data? For this, total how many customers are there? Total 14 customers are there. 14 customers are there. Out of this, this portion will be the 14 customers. Out of that, ordering a product. Always make sure that while building the decision tree, tree is nothing but one kind of tree. This is the one tree. This is the one tree. In this tree, always you are dependent variable. What you are trying to predict, order the product or not ordering the product. Always, not only here in this problem, in each and every problem in the real time scenario also, the top node, this is the root node. The portion which is here, the total 14 here, this portion is the root node. The root node will be always your dependent variable. The root node always, not only in this case, in each and every case, in the real time scenario also, in each and every case, the root node will be your dependent variable. Here there are total 14 customers are there. Out of that, 10 customers are not ordering the product. 4 customers are ordering the product. Here in this case, percentages. No percentage will be 10 divided by 14. Yes is the 4 divided by 14. Here male, out of 14 customers, male customers are 8 customers and female customers are the 6 customers. When I combine the 8 plus 6, it should be equal to 14. Out of 8 males, 7 males are not ordering the product. 1 male is ordering the product. 7 divided by 8, 1 divided by 8. 6 customers, out of 6 customers, 3 customers are not, out of 6 female customers, 3 customers are as ordering the product and remaining 3 are not ordering the product. 50-50%. And 8 males, out of 8 males, 6 are married customers and 2 are the unmarried customers. Am I right? 6 divided by 6, that is 100%. 0 divided by 6, that is the 0%. In the no means 1 by 2. In the 6 female customer, 3 are a married customer, 3 are unmarried customer. In the married customers, 3 are married female customers are not ordering the product. And none of the married customers are, none of the female married customers are ordering the product. But whereas in the unmarried female customers, 3 out of 3 are ordering the product. It clearly indicates this first one, the first portion will be the root node will be, this is the root node. This will be the child node. Male and female are the child node. This will be your leaf nodes. This will be your leaf nodes. Always, every case, in every case, You will make the decision by using the leaf nodes. Always, you will make a decision by using the leaf nodes. Always, you will make the decision by using the leaf node. Here, what kind of decision we are making? Yet, welcome. Here,
this can be again divided.
How? How?
Yes or no? 6 million. So how many unbanked or how many are not banked?
That is out of six are not buying, right?
Six are not buying.
Six no means not buying. Zero means zero. Yes.
Second, two unmarried. One bank, one not.
Then how do you divide again?
One bank.
Again we are divide that only, right? The same only, right? It's clearly given the information.
It is two unmarried.
This one. Here again it is one. Then the same only, right? Here one means one, no one, as we mentioned already, right? There no need to again divide it. It clearly indicates from this graph or from this decision tree what happens. Married male or married female are not at all buying the product. Even unmarried male customer percentage of probability. 50% means percentage of the probability. Buying the product is 50%. That means male unmarried customers also buying the probability only 50%. For example, if I target the two unmarried male customers, how many of them will buy the product? Only one customer will buy the product. Let's say if I target 100 customers, 50 customers only will buy the product. Is it a good option for me or is it a bad option for me? Definitely it is going to be a bad option. The reason is, now how many customers I am going to target? 100 unmarried male customers if I target. How many customers I am going to get? Respond, 50%. So am I investing the money for only 50 customers or am I investing the money for 100 customers? 100 customers. Yet clearly indicate that out of 50, only if I target the two people, one person is buying, other person is not buying. That means I am going to get the return on only the 50%, right? Randomly, there is no need to build the algorithm or model for randomly select the two people. You can clearly get to know one person is buying, one person is not buying. For that, there is no need to invest the money for the making the algorithm or some decision. You can randomly select the people and you can target it. It is not at all a good idea. But what is the best idea here? If I target the female unmarried customer, if I target the female unmarried customer, what does they do? 100%. So if I target the unmarried female customer, what is the probability buying the product? 100%. So each and every unmarried female customers are buying the product. Then in this case, who is my first preference to target the customer? Unmarried female customers is my first preference. So here, while making the leaf nodes or decision, always make sure that we are looking for the perfect decision. Perfect decision means perfect. Each and every, this is the one node, married, this is the one node, this is the other node, this is the one more node, this is the one more. Each and every box we call as the node. Each and every box here we call as the node. While making the decision, we are always looking for the dominating node. Dominating node is nothing but the node which giving the clear picture for us. Clear decision making picture plan, picture for us. That is called as the dominating node. Here in this case, what is happening? Here in this case, how do we make the decision? You may get the two questions. First, always for each and every business problem, the dependent variable should be your root node. Root node means this is the root node. But other questions you may get, why did you take the male and female customer first? This portion. Why did you consider male and female customer first? Why don't you consider married and unmarried? Why don't you consider married and unmarried? let's keep this question in our mind for some time. I will try to give a clarification going forward for this question. Here, gender, male and female, we have used the two variables. One is the gender. Under the gender, we have male and female. Second one is marital status, married and unmarried. Why do we consider gender as a first child node and leaf nodes as a married? Can't we consider marital status as a first variable, gender as a leaf node? That could be a possible, but why we haven't considered it? Whether we have done it correctly or not? Let me keep this question in your mind for some time. I will going forward, I will clarify it. Now, so male married customers are ordering the product or not ordering the product? No, male married customers are not ordering the product. Female unmarried customers, yes, they are ordering the product. How do you get to know? Based on this data only, we will get to know whether they are ordering the product or not ordering the product. Any questions so far?
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Yes, sir.
Here, the data will be bifurcating through gender. For example, leaf node always pointing to the head node. Based on that, we have bifurcated the data. In real-time data also, is it possible to every time in through gender or any other attributes it's there?
See, in the real-time, here in this case, we consider the gender. In the, all the cases, there is no guarantee gender will be there. Some other variable will be there. Based on that variable, we need to split it. But in the real-time also, your dependent variable, the top node, root node will be your... root node will be always your dependent variable in real time also, everywhere.
Okay.
But here the remaining variable,
whatever leaf pointing to the head, head is always to the dependent variable, right?
Yeah. Yes. The head point is called as the root node.
Okay. Fine.
The root node will be always your dependent. Remaining leaf nodes will change. Your chain nodes will be changed. Everything will be changed. And the how do we draw the algorithm also we are going to look into now. How do we draw this decision tree also we are going to look, which variable will come into the significant, all these things we are going to look into. Yes, the aim is to decide the whole population or the data into segment. Segment means groups. The segment may be useful for the business decision. One class really dominating means giving a pure clarity. Now, pure clarity means, let's say, married male or female customers, they are not at all buying the product. That means, whenever I'm going to target the customer in the future, am I going to target the married customers? Either it may be female customer or male customer. I'm not going to target at all. Does it give a clear picture to me? Yes. Female unmarried customers are buying the product. What does it mean? So 100% they are buying the product. What does it mean? The customers, female customers are buying the product 100%. So 100%. So it means whenever I am going to target the customer, my first preference will be female unmarried customer. When can we say one particular node or a box is a dominating node? The percentage of the node to understanding point. To the percentage of the node is more than 75%, then only we can say the node is a dominating node. When the percentage of the node 75%, then only we can say it is a positive node or negative. It can be positive or negative. So let's say 95% of the male customers are not buying the product. That means, what is the probability customers are buying the product? 5%. 95% is the negative or positive? Negative. So in negative also, it giving a clear picture. So when I am targeting the customer, I clearly know that I am not going to target the male customer. I am going to target the female customer. Here, dominating node, to understand as a layman terms, dominating node means the node which is having the more than 75% either positive or negative, that node is called as the dominating. One more important point, your node is 50-50. We are never ever going to consider. So the reason is we are going to get the revenue of only 50%. So that is the reason we are not at all going to consider those kind of the scenario. Let me give an example. For example, there is 50% chance customer will buy, 50% chance customer are not buying. If I know that 50% customers are buying, 50 customers not buying, then do I need to run the model or do I need to run the campaign? Not required. Every 2%, 1% will buy. For every 100 customer, 50% will buy. Then there is no need to run the algorithm. There is no required to say the great skill also. Let's say India Australia matches happen. For example, let's say I said that India, there is 50% chances India is going to win, 50% chances Australia is going to win. Does it make you curiosity? No. Generally, everyone can able to say, right? Even you don't know anything of the basics of the cricket also, you can say, yeah, either may Australia win or may India win. What is the 50-50? Let's say if I toss a card, it can be a head or it can be a tail. Then you are not a great predictor. If I said, yes, definitely it is going to be head, 90% chances it is going to be head, or 10% chances it is going to be a tail, then only you are a great predictor. Yes, it can be a head or it can be a tail. Definitely it is not going to be a good, you are not good to be a data scientist. Either it need to be more than 75%, either positive or negative. It doesn't mean always positive. It can be a negative also, so that it will get a clear idea. A good split criteria, the customer with 90-10%. Let's say gender is equal to female, customers have 5% buying probability and 95% are not buying. What does it mean? So it clearly indicates that 95% of the female customers are not buying the product. Only 5% of the female customers are buying the product. When I'm going to target, or when I'm applying the strategy, am I going to target the female customers? No. Here the 95%, is it the positive or negative? Negative. So even it is a negative also, it gives a clear picture of a business strategy. So while making the strategy, whether it is a positive or negative, the particular node be a dominating node when it is more than 75, plus or minus, it can be negative 75 or plus 75. Then only we can say it is a decision is a good or dominating node. But in the real time, we are not going 75%. There is a method called as entropy. Based on that, we will decide. But as a layman term to understand, as we mentioned, 75%. Now, total population is 100. Let's come up with the total population is 100. Here, 50 based on the age. We are doing based on the age as an example. 50 in the total population, 50% customers are buying the product. 50% of the customers are not buying the product. Then, can we say total population is a good node? Will it be helpful for business decision making? No. The reason 50% now buying a 50%, there is no great school. There is no need to build the algorithm. What about the entire total population has been classified into two things: young population as well as the old population. The young population has been classified as 60, and the old population has been classified as the 40. Young population is 60 and old population is 40. When I adding up young plus old, 60 plus 40 should be equal to total population, right? Here, out of young population, 31 customers are buying the product, 29 customers are not buying the product. In the old population, 19 customers are buying the product and 21 customers are not buying the product. 31 divided by 60, 19 divided by 40. In this case, we got the 52%. 31 divided by 60 is nothing but 52%. 19 divided by 48%. So in this case, is it a best node or a bad node? 50 chance 50 to 50. Then when a particular node is more than 75%, whether it is positive or negative, then only we can say that it is a dominating node. In this case, it is not happening as a dominating node. So we can say that this is not the best node for the segmentation. We cannot divide the based on the segmentation. So age is not giving the good dominating nodes. So we cannot split the data. We cannot consider the age as the best node. Can we go with the example? Let's say now I would like to discuss about based on the gender. Here also the total population is 100. 50% customers are buying the product. 50% of the customers are not buying the product. So as the root node is a best node to split dominating node, can we say as a root node is a dominating node? No, root node is not a dominating node. In the root, in the gender, out of total population, male has been classified as 60 and female has been classified as the 40. In the male node, 48 customers are buying the product and 12 customers are not buying the product. Whereas in the female customer, out of 40, 2 customers are buying, 38 customers are not buying the product. When I target in the customer, here 48 divided by 60 and 2 divided by 40. So it giving a clear picture. Female customers are going to buy the product only 5%. That means 95% of the female customers are not buying the product. Is it a dominating node? Yes, it is going to be a dominating. If you talk about in the terms of the male also, 80% of the male customers are buying the product and remaining 20% of the male customers are not. Even it is also good decision made. So when I consider the gender as well as age, which is the dominating node? Does the age is a dominating node or does the gender is the best node? Gender is the best node. The reason is, if you want to target the customer based on gender and age, in the gender it giving a more clear picture about the data to whom we need to target. Does we need to target male customer or does we need to target the female customer? It giving a clear picture about the data. But whereas in the age case, it is not giving the clear picture. It is giving the 50-50 chances. So we cannot come up with a conclusion based on the age, but we can come up with a conclusion based on the gender. That is how we will do. Okay. Now we discuss about the two variables, gender as well as the age. Gender as well as the age. In here, how many variables we have? Only two variables. Gender is the one variable and age is the one variable. Okay. We are looking for the dominating segment. Dominating is nothing but pure segment. In the data set, in the real-time data set, which is the many number of variables, which is the attribute, right attribute for the pure segment. Here two variables, you come up with a conclusion. But if you have thousands of variables, how do you come up with the pure segment? Can we start with the any attribute? First, let's say x1 to x100, x2, x3, x2, and so on, x1000. Can I start with x1, or can I start with x2, or can I start with x3, or can I start with x4, or can I start with x999, or can I start with x1000? Which variable I need to start? Which is the best variable to split the separating the attribute? Let's say customer age. It can impact the sales. It can impact the gender, can impact the sales. Demographic can impact the sales. And how do you identify the best split attribute? This is whatever we are discussing here, all these things, which is the background of the decision trees. The writing the syntax or algorithm is one line, but discussing the we are discussing what is happening in the background. You may get the clarity in some time, maybe today or tomorrow. Any questions, guys, so far? No? Any questions, guys, who are on the call?
No quoty.
Thank you. Is everyone got the clear idea what is happening? Now, how do we split the criteria? The best split is the split does the best job separating the data into groups. Group is nothing but one box or nodes are called as the where the single class is a predominant each in group. 0 or 1 means buying or not buying. Yes or no condition. Then only we can get the clarity. Now, does the age is a dominating node or not in this case? Age is not a dominating node. The reason here 50-50 chances. Whenever it is more than 75%, then only we can say that age is a particular variable is a best split attribute. But in the age case, it is giving only 50 to 48%. We cannot say age is the best split attribute. What about the gender? Gender is the best split. If I want to consider the best split attribute, gender versus age, which is the attribute we can consider as a best split attribute? We can consider gender as the best split attribute rather than the age variable. We can consider the gender as the best split attribute rather than the age variable. Here, always we are looking for the impurity or diversity that will give the highest score for the age variable. That means high impurity. That means impurity opposite of purity is the impurity. Always we are looking for the purity node. High impurity means that node is not the perfect node. That means it will give the high score for the age variable. High impurity means high score for the age variable. Low score for the gender variable. To measure the high impurity or diversity, we are going to use the formula called entropy. Entropy is nothing but, of course, here we cannot go manually, right? In the real time, we need to do the some algorithm for that. There is a function called entropy. In entropy point of view, the matter, what do you mean by entropy? Entropy means it characterizes the impurity or diversity of a segment. That means measure the uncertainty or unimpurity of the node. How do we measure the impurity? Let me have a discussion. Uncertainty or impurity of the data. It measures the uncertainty or impurity of the data. The formula to calculate the entropy S is equal to minus P into log 2 P plus minus Q into log 2 Q. P is nothing but probability of success. That is nothing but positive events. For example, buying or not buying. Buying is the positive, not buying is the negative. That is the probability of success. Q is nothing but probability of failure. P is nothing but probability of success, or Q is nothing but probability of failure. Now, here, the entropy will be high for the entropy will be high for the impure nodes, impurity node. Entropy will be low for the purity nodes. Entropy will be high for the impure nodes. Entropy will be low for the purity nodes. Okay. Now. Okay. Now, to calculate the entropy, the formula for the entropy is S is equal to minus P into log 2P minus Q into log 2Q. Let's say here the total population is, total population, let's calculate the entropy is, total population 100 records, 50 are buying, 50 are not buying. Plus means buying, minus means not buying. Let's calculate the entropy value. The probability value is P is equal to 50 by 100, Q is equal to 50 by 100. Am I right? So the formula is 50 by 100 is nothing but 0.5, Q also 0.5. Probability of success is nothing, total number of positive events by total number of events. Negative is nothing, total number of negative events by total. So the formula is minus 0.5 into log 2 of 0.5 minus 0.5 into log 2 of 0.5. Here minus 0.5 log 2 of minus 1, log 2 of 0.5 is the minus 1, minus 0.5 into log 2 of minus 1. Minus 0.5 is the plus 0.5 plus 0.5, that is equal to 1. Even if you have a doubt, log 2 of log 0.5 base 2 is, let's go to the Excel for your clarification. So is equal to log of number 0.5, comma here asking the base. What is the base value? 2. That is the minus 1. Right? So if you come up with this, that, so minus 0.5 log 2 base is the minus 1. Minus 0.5 into minus 1. Minus into minus plus 0.5. That is equal to 1. That means entropy is the 50-50 chances. That is a 50% buying and 50% not buying. What is the entropy value? 1. That is 50% 50% chances. The entropy value will be 1. Is it clear? Let's say in another example, total population is 100. 100 customers are buying, 0 customers are not buying. 100 plus means 100 total customers are buying. Zero means not buying. Zero means not buying. Here in this case, how we are going to do? The formula is minus P into log 2 P. S is equal to minus P into log 2 P minus Q into log 2 Q. Minus P is the how much? P is equal to 100 by 100. That is equal to 1. Q is equal to 0 by 100. 0. That means minus 1 into log 2 1 minus 0 into log 2 0. Minus 1 into log 2 1 is the 0 minus 0, that is equal to 0. You may get a doubt, log 2 1 is the, again go to the Excel sheet. Here log of 1, number 1, that is the base is 2, 0. Anything log 1 value, I mean log 10 base, I mean log 1 base 10, log 1 base 2, log 1 base 4, log 1 base 3, anything, the value will be 0. Now here in this case, if it is a pure segment, if it is a pure segment, 100% clear picture. 100% customers are buying. Total customers are buying. That means the entropy value will be zero. That means entropy is formulated in such a way that entropy value will be low for the pure segment. Entropy value will be high for the impure segment. Entropy value will be low for pure segment. Entropy value will be high for impure segments. Right? Okay. Now, entropy is not going to split the attributes. It is not going to use for this selecting the attribute. Attribute is nothing but variable. But it is helping us to split the nodes or to split the level of the attribute. Clear indication purpose. Entropy is not going to use for split the attribute. Attribute is nothing but variable. It is helping us to split the nodes of a attribute. Nodes means levels. Let's say gender, male, female is the, male is the one level and female is the another node. Male is the one node, female is another. Age, male, I mean gender, male, female, like young, old, like sex. I mean let's say you can salary, employed, salaried or unemployed, employed, unemployed, like this kind of thing. Okay. Clear indication purpose. Entropy is not going to use for the split the attribute. It is helping us to split the nodes of a attribute. Nodes means levels of a attribute. Means split of a nodes of a attribute means levels of a levels of a attribute. Levels of a attribute. Okay. Now, how do you calculate the entropy for the remaining things? Okay. Shall we do one by one? Any questions about this so far? Okay. Now, let me start the example again. So, we have discussed entropy for the when the is the one already we discussed this. This also we discuss. The less the entropy, the better the split. Entropy is formulated. It will be high for the impure segment. It is low for the. Now calculation example. This is the root node and let's say we calculate the old and young population. Let's say this segment. Let's say old and young population for this segment. Enter this segment. Old and young population. Here in this case, age is equal to young segment has 60 records which consist of 31 are the buying customers or 21 are the not buying customers. P is nothing but the formula. Same formula is here. P plus is nothing but P value. P minus is nothing but Q value. You can write the same. No one, as per your wish to donate in the number. But actual formula this one. For our convenience purpose, I have created like that. 31 by minus 31 by 60 log to 31 by 60 minus 29 by 60 into log to of 29 by 60. So the value is 0.999184. Is a pure segment or impure segment? Impure segment, because it is a 99%. If the entropy value is reaching towards the 1, then we can say it is an impure segment. If the entropy value reaching towards the 0, we can say it is the pure segment. Let's say, can we do this for old segment? In the old segment, how many records we have? 40 records. Out of that, 19 are the buying the product and buying the product. 21 customers are not buying the product. Here in this case also, we got the entropy values 99%. Here also, the old segment is in a pure segment or impure segment. The entropy value in the old segment also reaching towards the 1. it is also impure segment. We cannot consider as the pure segment. The reason is that in this case, we have the towards the one. That means the pure. It is not giving a clear picture of the data. Now, what about this case? Calculate the entropy at the root node for the given population. Here, in the, if I calculate the entropy for the root nodes, what is the entropy value? 50-50. Then entropy value will be 1. Here is the male segment we can calculate and female segment. Male segment, if we calculate, the entropy value is 72%. Female segment will calculate entropy at the 2%, 28%. Now, here when I consider the male segment and female segment, which is the dominating node? The entropy which is the less, the entropy the value which is the less, that is the dominating node. Here, of course, here the male and female segment we are looking. As compared to the male segment, female segment is giving more clear indication that 95% of the female customers are not buying the product. 90% of the female customers are not buying the product. Right? Now, if I want to a clear indication in this case, male segment and female segment. So, the female segment is giving more clear picture rather than the male segment. So, female segment is the more pure segment rather than the male segment. Now, if I here this is the root node, total population is the root node, the male and female are the child nodes. Now, next attribute I want to start. Where I need to start? Do I need to start under the male segment or do I need to start under the female segment? Definitely, we are going to start under the female segment. The reason is that wherever the entropy is less, that portion only we are going to consider. The remaining portion, we are going to left it like this. The remaining portion, we are going to left it as usual. We won't consider. The next attribute we are considering is under the female segment. We are going to consider under the female segment. Clear? Any confusion, guys? Here in the entropy, no, yes, go ahead.
Koti, the 5% means impurity only, right?
5%. 5% means impurity, but the meaning is that 5% means 95% of the customers are not buying. Here 5% which indicates that only 5% customers are buying the product and remaining 95% customers are not buying the product. If I consider here, 5% means only 5% customers are buying the product. 95% of the customers are not buying the product. When I consider the male customer, 80% of the customer are buying the product. As I mentioned, the dominating node means whether it is a positive or negative. Here it clearly indicates that 95% of the customers are not buying. So that it gives us the more picture, not targeting the female customers. Maybe while doing the segmentation, if I get to know who I am not targeting customer, then I clearly get to know who am I going to target. Can you please keep the mic in the mute? Greek. Here in this case, it clearly tells us about 95% of customers are not buying the product. That means if you know the unknown item, then we can get to know the easily classify the unknown. I mean, if you know the some item, we can easily get to know the unknown item. Clearly indicates about the male female customers are not buying. Of course, we are buying the customer, but here in this case, that means we are not buying, we are cut out. But in some cases, here we are not clear, we are not sure. Rather, we need to target which one we need to segment. Do I need to segment the buying customers or not buying customers? They did not clearly mention that point first. They did not clearly mention the first point. Do I need to target the buying customer or not buying? Just they given us the idea to split the attribute.
In ideal cases,
we may target the buying customer. In that case, we need to target the male customers only. But I am talking which node is the powerful node. Ideal cases, we need to target the buying customer. I agree for all of you. But here we are talking about the purity node or impurity node. Based on the entropy, we will measure the uncertainty of the node. It will give the pure or impure. If the entropy reaching towards the zero, that is the pure node. If entropy reaching the towards one, that is the impure node. In this case, just I am looking for the pure segment in the comparing the male and female, which giving the more clarity whether it is a positive way or negative way. The female customer giving the more clarity rather than the male customer. So I am saying that entropy is the less for the female customer. That is the meaning of this one. Sai, is it clear?
Yes, good.
Yes, generally everyone is correct. We are always looking for the buying customer. But in this case, we are just looking for the pure or impure nodes based on the formula wise. So, and information gain. What do you mean by information gain? Entropy, as I clearly indicate that, entropy only split the nodes of a attribute. It doesn't help us to split the best variable. To split the best variable, we are going to use the called information gain. Information gain, in interview also they might ask you n number of times. Information gain means entropy before the split minus entropy after the split. Easy way to understand the information gain: overall entropy at the parent node minus sum of weighted entropy at each child node. The attribute with the maximum information, that is the best split attribute. That means wherever we have the maximum entropy gain, that attribute we can consider as the first split, first variable. Wherever we have the maximum information gain, that we can consider as the best split attribute. In interview also many number of times was the question, what do you mean by information gain? Information gain means, information gain will help us to identify the best split attribute. The formula for the information gain is entropy at the root node minus sum of weighted entropy at each child node. Okay, so how do we calculate the information gain? So information gain we are calculating for the whole. Let's say here we have a two variables, gender variable as well as the age variable. Does the gender variable is the best variable or does the age variable is the best variable? First, what is the formula? Entropy at the root node minus sum of weighted entropy at the each child node. Entropy overall population is 100, how much? 100%, right? As we get the 1, that is 100. Entropy for your young segment is 99%. Entropy for the old segment is the 99%. Information gain is entropy at the root node minus sum of weighted entropy at each child. That is 100 minus sum of weighted means what is the young population is 60%, old population is 40%. How do you get to know 60 divided by 100, 40 divided by 100? 60 divided by 100 into 0.99 plus 0.4, that is 40 divided by 100 into 0.99, that is equal to 1. The same way we are doing the for the gender variable. Here we got the 45.2. In the two cases, which is the best split attribute? The attribute which is the maximum information. Where I am getting the maximum information? We are getting the maximum information for the gender variable. So we are going to consider the gender variable as the best split attribute. The 72 means here the male segment is 72%. Thus the same, this is the formula. 72. Female is the 28. This is the formula. 28 means 0.19, that is the 29%. This is the fact. So the information gain which is high for the gender variable. Fortunately, we are not going to calculate manually the entropy information. System will calculate. It will give the final output. You need to able to understand what happened. How do you get this? To understand that point, we need to understand first what is the entropy, what is the information gain. No need to calculate, no need to draw manual. Automatic system will take care about this. Let's do a one lab. Calculate the information gain example based on the variable split. Split one with respect to the car. Having the car, not having the car. Total population speaking and respect the gender. We have a owning a car, we have the gender. Based on the gender buying the customers or based on the owning a car, customer buy the product or not. Out of total population is 67. Out of that, 28 customers are buying, 39 customers are not buying the product, and 42% is the buying pattern. Yes or no, male or female. So which is the best split attribute? Owning a car is a 50.6. Information for gender is 10.8. Then which variable I can consider the best split attribute? Owning a car is the best split attribute. Here chi-square measure of association means other purity or diversity measures. If you are using the, here we are using the information gain or information gain ratio. In R language, we can call with the information gain. In SAS language, if you want to do the decision tree, we are using the chi-square measure. The same formula, we are using the chi-square. But whereas in the Python, we can consider as the Gini index. Misclassification error means the percentage of error, as we get the 1 minus accuracy is nothing but misclassification error. The accuracy means as we calculated yesterday, like true positive plus true negative divided by sum of all these things. That is the meaning of misclassification error. We will discuss all these things later in the other tools also. Guys, any questions about till now? That is the first part of the decision trees for today.